I am the one who's offensive because I'm portraying this Russian guy to be crazy and alcoholic. So, you know, if there's any social justice warriors out there, it's me they'll be sharpening the pikes for.
Great. Fucking great.
Alright, we'll just go ahead and get started. Joseph said he's going to be a few minutes late. And I haven't heard from Alex. So...
Yeah.
And I already know that Jack is not going to... is sick, so he's not going to be coming.
Yep. Unfortunately.
So... where we left off, you guys had met a very drunk, angry, possibly crazy Russian in Igor Petrovsky.
Actually, I wasn't drunk. I was...
You were wanting to be drunk.
I was suffering from withdrawal, actually, so quite the opposite. But I think that the priest was getting a little crazy and drunk.
Yeah. And after that, you know, with tension in England rising and everybody seeming to be out to get you guys, you decided to slip out of the country quietly and make your way to Cairo. And that's
well,
yes.
As quietly as we can.
Yes, as quietly as you can.
And I decided to tag along because I'm under the impression that the same people are after me and the group, and mostly I want to get as far away from NKVD agents as I can. And I'm seeing Russian spies everywhere who want to kidnap me and bring me back home. And so I tagged along. I think that's how I came to be part of the expedition, no?
Yes.
Yep, sounds about right.
You've already made a mistake.
While you guys are on the run, I need you to make luck rolls.
Oh god fucking damn it. Okay, so who's gonna start? At least someone is success. I didn't expect that. I mean, I didn't expect that. So, yeah, good rolls.
A lot of luck.
If you notice, we have really low luck. What the fuck?
I'm making a few rolls because it's going to be a group luck roll, so the majority will win out.
Oh, it's majority fails.
Okay. Majority fails. But wow, yeah. That was a good luck roll.
Yeah, it's sort of like 50-50 more like, but yeah. Since it's hard. At least it doesn't matter.
All right. On your travels, you start noticing that the temperature has changed from a wintry, cold, dreary north to a more comfortable and almost warm Mediterranean weather as you've gone from England down to southern France.
Oh, so what you actually meant to say is it's fucking hot and disgusting and uncomfortable.
Well, no, it's not.
Some of you will find it very hot and uncomfortable and disgusting.
Yeah, exactly. Right, Igor?
Yeah,
yes, I'm very warm and I don't like it.
You managed to catch a small ship to take you from England to France, and then you hopped trains to take you from north to south, staying always on the move so that no one can find out where you are, and never staying in one place for too long.
Exactly.
But now while you're waiting for a boat to take you across the Mediterranean. You're sitting in a, you go to sit in a small, a small little coffee shop.
Of course.
And of course, it's a coffee shop. And Dr. Graham, you'll know this is Paris, or this is France, so there's, the coffee is really good, really high quality.
It's actually, that's actually bad, because I very mostly try to take coffee that's actually not, I mean, maybe it's a good quality, but I don't drink it for taste, I drink it actually, the better, the worse it tastes, the better, so I drink the pain away, and I suffer.
Alright, but while you guys are sitting down and just chatting amongst yourselves, a figure walks into the coffee shop and sits down at your table. He's tall, thin, with a very short mustache, beady black eyes, and he has his fingers pressed up against themselves, like right up against his chest. And he's smiling.
Does he look like a
Does
he look like a Russian?
No, he does not. Okay. But he does have a
Charlie Chaplin Hitler mustache.
No, it's it's like a thin mustache that goes right above his upper lip. Not a Hitler mustache.
Ah. A vintage villain mustache.
Yes.
Well, if he starts the conversation with, well, I think we know where this is going.
It's interesting to see you here.
Don't you find it rude to not introduce yourself?
Oh. Introduce myself, well. You insist.
I know people do that stuff. It's hard to imagine.
It is. I've been all around the world and people can be so rude. I, however, am not one of them. I am Mr. Henry Akerley. Pleasure to make your acquaintance.
My name is Dr. Hermann Granum.
I know.
PhD Igor Petrovsky at your service.
Petrovsky. How interesting. I really wouldn't have figured you to have come this way. I thought the Americans would have snapped you up as soon as you had left Russia.
You seem to know a lot about me, sir. I find myself at a disadvantage.
You can consider me as some sort of a teacher or a scholar of sorts.
This is worrying.
Mr. Selden?
I'll say I didn't look to see me become an experiment.
No. I mean you no ill will. Just wanted to meet you and have a little chat.
Well, you certainly started an interesting one.
Yes.
Feel free to tell us all about yourself and what you do.
Like I said, I'm a researcher and a scholar. I just travel around the world, seeing what I may see, meeting new and interesting people.
Getting information on people? Spying on them?
No. Nothing as blasé as that.
You just bought the information, I see. Just...
Oh.
Sorry if I'm being late.
And how do you know me, sir? How do you know any of us?
Pastor, we just found our personal stalker.
Ah, cool. I like stalkers.
Mr. Henry, I didn't not get the other one. Name.
Akerley.
Not a good one, Pastor. Not a good one. kind of stalker.
Please do not treat him like the others. Please.
Oh, Pastor Joseph Myers. Yes, I feel we share a kinship of sorts. Though you kinship. Might not see it that way.
What way would you think that?
Oh, let's just say that we both like to see it, think of ourselves as messengers.
Yeah, the difference between you and me is I'm correct.
The difference between you and me, sir, is that you believe you're correct. And I know that I am.
I'm pretty sure I said it the other way around. But okay. So, Mr. Henry? Can I call you Henry?
Sure.
All right.
You can call me anything you wish. I have a fondness for titles.
Okay, that's good to know. I'm not very good with surnames anyway.
What can we do for you, or what can you do for us?
I mean, better question is, what do you want from us?
I just wanted to meet you and see you for myself before we're in much darker places.
Okay, you now got my attention. What is your business?
Nothing. I have no business. I'm just meeting you. And enjoying some coffee. And perhaps a pastry. I'll have to get something. I hear the French are very talented with their cooking.
Sure. You just come visit us and and nothing wrong. You just know our names, know what we are, who are we? Yeah, totally normal. Yeah, listen, I don't know how other gentlemen sat here, but I don't like stalkers.
I'm not a stalker, Dr. Granum.
Yeah, I already heard you call yourself more like an observant. Is that right?
Yes, that's a great way. I study things. I study people, study events.
Yeah.
Oh, let's get back to your point with you're wanting to meet us before it gets dark in the metaphorical sense.
Yes.
What did you mean by that?
Pastor. I mean that it'll be dark. The places you'll go, the things you'll do. I fear that your accomplishments will go unrecognized.
It's the duty of the little man to serve for the greater good.
Yes, well.
I'm gonna just say this. People that come our way.
Shh, doctor.
Perhaps you can help us to shed light on what's about to happen.
The future hasn't been determined yet. It's all your own choices that matter.
Oh, please. I think you are so observant. I'm pretty sure we can find also a talent of yours, like predicting future.
No, there's no predicting the future. I could make a guess, but that's not really the point. I observe what has happened. I can look through all your pasts. For example, Dr. Granum, who was Jesse? I think you know. I sure know. But do they know?
Doctor?
Give me a minute, I actually don't know who is Jesse.
You drink so much coffee, you've got amnesia.
Yes, actually, I'm just looking at him and I'm like... Cute! You're a pretty bad observant. I don't know that person. Now I'm gonna play it and I forget about him. Through that coffee, depression and all of it. Makes sense. Sure.
Really? Because I can see into your mind's memories and I know the woman that you loved.
Oh, right.
Mr. Eckelow?
I know.
Yes.
I know.
Not that I want to sound rude or anything, but I want to hear the story from the doctor's mouth, not yours. If you know, you get the point.
Of course.
There is no story. I really don't know what he's talking about.
And you're telling the truth, Doctor.
What?
You're telling the truth about that, Doctor.
Yes.
May I
just I look at him confused.
Do I believe he's telling us the truth?
You can tell that I'm the that
oh,
I am.
Oh, what fun it made. Is to see all this confusion and.
I just wanna make like tell Harold what probably he did it. Maybe it seems a little bit weird because you maybe think like I lie, but I don't realize it, like something like that. Like I lie intentionally, like I don't realize it.
Okay.
So yeah, that's happening at all.
I think we find out about this Jesse person in the near future, I assume that. Did you already tell us what could enlighten us in this dark path we will go through when we are traveling to Egypt, like Mr. Selden asked you? I'm talking to Henry again.
If I had to make a suggestion,
please.
I would consider not, because it'd be more fun to see what you do.
It's a shame. I hate being unprepared.
And I don't like stalkers. Did I mention that?
Yes, you did.
Oh, wait. You call it observant, right?
Observant.
Yeah, that's the new term.
You know the people who study the ways of the human mind, how humans behave. Those two are exactly the same, Doctor.
It's creepy.
It's more of the human behavior that I look for, but. It's just a hobby of mine.
Yeah. It's creepy.
Tell me, I think you won't be staying around here for the entire time. I get the feeling that we will see you down there in Egypt. Is that correct? To assume?
You can assume what you like. You may or may not.
But I'd you like want... That.
You want to know something very interesting? I don't know if you've picked up on it. We have already met.
Oh.
Oh, wait.
Can I make an intelligence roll to May remember?
Yeah, can I also?
Yes, you guys can.
Oh, for f-
I
I call bullshit.
Wow.
Oh, I think Igor also saw him, so yeah, I remember as a player. Igor saw him too. Igor saw him too.
Ha.
Igor, you remember the police officers who came into the hotel room, and who had looked at all of you and said thought how interesting it was that you chose to lie.
It was more like, you lied.
You lied.
Deeply.
Interesting.
You're not really a cop, are you?
I never said I was.
What do you mean with he's not a cop?
Because he came in with, what was it, three other policemen? Or with three policemen, and we all assumed that he was another policeman.
Oh, you mean yesterday?
Yeah. This is... I see.
How long have you been observing us? I'm actually quite interested right now.
Probably a few years.
No. You only garnered my attention recently.
Of course.
So only like when we were here in London, so not back when where we came from, like New York or I don't know.
You mean you want to know if I knew what happened with the murder of Jackson Elias?
Well, it went to the news, so it wouldn't be a surprise if you know that. I mean, it wasn't a newspaper article about it.
The newspaper reported Elias's death, but they didn't report on the carving in his forehead, or the gunshots, or how Jackson was left to bleed, or any of the minor details that the papers didn't report on.
Okay, so you did your research. I'm actually very surprised.
By stalking!
Yes, I know that. Do you really think I'm that of an idiot, Doctor?
I just like to be annoying towards that person.
I try to take a good look at my companions, and I want to figure out if they seem unsettled by the implications this man is doing. Do they look like they know more about their letting on about this particular murder?
That I don't know. Do you guys react to what he said?
We have told you like some things.
Not
everything, but yeah, we have told you some things. Out of character talk, we have told you some things with the mention and everything. Sort of. Not everything though, but part of it.
We tell you more when we're back in the hotel room. I don't like talking while the police is around.
I am not the police.
Yeah, I know that, but...
You are more annoying.
That already. You are definitely a spy. Or at least counterintelligence officer, if the word is the more tasteful that way.
You seem to think that I'm aligned with some political entity. But I assure you, that's not the case.
Of course.
Going deeper and darker then. Okay, this is getting interesting. So what is the nature of your interest in us?
I'm just interested in what you've been doing and...
Of course, but
who you are.
Would you share the reason why with us?
I could. But then it would be, it's much more fun to leave you a little bit of doubt.
How many people is nearby?
All the investigators, and there are a couple other people in the cafe. I'd probably say 3 or 4 people.
Investigate what?
Oh, you mean all of you guys? Yeah.
And other 3 people. Are they like looking? Are they like busy doing sort of stuff?
They are sitting there. They're not paying attention to you.
Okay.
How do they look? These 3 other people.
You can make a spot hidden roll.
Sure.
Not again.
actually succeeded.
Why did I pass?
You guys notice that the other patrons in the cafe are not moving.
Oh.
Okay.
Here we go again.
Sorry, I didn't mean to roll that many times. I thought it didn't work.
It's alright.
Okay.
So ignore the success.
Okay.
Mr. Accolade,
I see you have friends. Of course you have.
Mr. Accolade, I still have a question. Why are you not related to any political organization, as Mr. Petrovsky here asked you? Are you involved in any kind of group? I mean, don't get me wrong, it's just highly... It's just highly logical to me to gather information of some people without having something in the back of his own mind.
Pastor, I think there are better things that interest him, like blood. Yeah.
Leans forward, he snaps his fingers while smiling. I'm only out for myself.
Can I roll a psychology roll if that's a lie?
You don't need to, that's obviously a lie.
I mean, the pastor doesn't know about it, obviously. Why do I roll so badly?
They're moving on a day.
Henry, I wonder if you would care to teach me how to perform that little trick of yours.
Which trick?
The one of stopping time.
Oh. That's one I can't teach. Sorry.
An innate ability of yours, is it?
You could say that, but... realistically, it's more of a... talent I have... because of my duties.
Duties. Of course.
To observe.
Can you show your teeth? Can you show your teeth, please? I'm just curious. If you eat healthy.
Guys, please excuse me. I need to step away for a minute. I'll be right back.
Okay. Alright.
What is his reaction to what I just said?
Confusion.
There is reason for it. If it's...
I think I'm... done with you for now.
Before you leave... show me your deeds.
My what?
Deeds. Toots. I want to see if you eat healthy.
I'm not playing any of your games. And he stands up and starts to walk away. As he does, the people in the rest of, in the cafe start to move again. And I need you to all make POW checks.
Right. What the?
I keep crying.
Alright, Pastor, you don't remember the conversation that just happened. Or the man that you just met.
Dr. Glennon, nice to see you here.
And as far as you're aware, Joseph, no time has passed.
Yeah, right.
I look at him. Hey! Huh. That was quite a gentleman.
Are you referring to me, Doctor?
Oh, I see. Ah, that's fucking annoying.
What?
Good that that trick doesn't work on me.
What was Henry wearing, by the way?
Who was Henry?
He was wearing
a gentleman that just
suit.
Left the cafeteria.
From what you remember.
Oh, you also remember, guys. Interesting.
Black suit, white shirt, black tie, black sunglasses.
Stalker, annoying, probably demon.
He didn't have black sunglasses on, nope. He just a suit and a tie.
God damn it, I wanted to see if he's a vampire.
It was also in the middle of the day, so you can rule that out right away.
I mean, I don't know nothing about, there could be vampires too, and I don't know if the vampires, they bother the sunlight or not, so I wanted to see if he's actually a vampire or not. Or if he actually, if he can, like, get his tea back or not, or whatever. I don't know, I just wanted to see if he's a vampire.
Have you lost the drinking?
Maybe there are many kinds of vampires, each with their own weaknesses and strengths.
Yeah.
Did you guys lost the bet to Mr. Potofsky, or why are you acting so out of touch with reality?
There was a guy, he talked to us, he was stalker, he was talking us. Do you remember when we were at the hotel room and cops come to us and there was the one dude that said, "You lied! Interesting," or something like that.
The one who said that to Jack? Yeah, I remember him.
That was him. He just came to us, say hello, said some creepy shit and leave. And apparently, stop time, I guess, and delete their mind.
Guys, please do not mix alcohol in the doctor's coffee.
we observed exactly the same thing. The only person that didn't, apparently, was yourself.
Yes.
Harold, I find that not funny. If you can stop the joke now, it's over, you got me.
I'm not joking. I'm not joking.
You seem to be under the effect of a substance that causes short-term memory loss.
It seems like the way. Yes.
Well, I didn't smell anything or...
Yeah, of course. Of course you don't. Demons do that.
I hope you haven't been looking around in my bag, have you?
Like I said, demons do that.
I am literally a pastor. I should know more about demons than you, Doctor. No offense, though.
Did you actually met one, though?
He may have been an angel.
I met my former girlfriend.
That's great. That's fucking great, Buster.
After about an hour or so, you are able to go and get on a boat to take you to the Suez Canal and the closest you can get to Cairo.
I was just
not Alexandria.
Just... No, the boat that you're picked up is not stopping in Alexandria.
I know, Anne.
So you get on the boat, it's relatively cheap, and it just brings you over. As you depart, get off the boat in Africa, I need you to all make luck rolls again.
Of course.
Hello, Henry.
Oh. Ah, close. I am wondering if I should spend the luck, I'm gonna see.
Yeah, spend one luck, please. Make it 18 to 22.
I'm gonna see. So how many people are... Still, it would be half people, right?
As you guys get off the boat,
Jack,
several police officers come and approach you. Papers, please.
Sure.
Hand over passport.
Okay.
With a £5 note in it.
Nah, that's a bad idea.
Are you bribing me?
Sorry,
this piece of paper. You bribing me?
No.
No, he was probably just tipping you for your good services. I hope. I am pretty sure he doesn't mean it in a bad way, right, Harold? Right, Harold?
Must have got stuck in there when I put some money in it in London.
Oh, or that? Yeah, that might.
Well,
be
that's good. That is a great tip, and in return, I'll give you one. This is Egypt. Barger. He hands back the passports. And if you must, tip highly. And the officers walk away.
Well, that was weird.
As you look around, now that the police have walked off, and you just see that the place is crowded. There are people everywhere. Shouting. Advertisement, flyers for different hotels, their services.
Can we go around them? Around the crowd?
This crowd is massive. I mean, you can't even see the end. The crowd goes all the way to the edge of the port. From one side of the dock to the other, these people it's like a mass, almost like a wall of people.
Can we see like a path that we can take to get out of the crowds as soon as possible?
You can make a spot hidden roll.
Of course. Ah, better. You have good eyes.
Harold and Igor, you think that there's a thin part of the crowd a little ways off to your right, where you might be able to get your way through without having to squeeze past a lot of people.
Follow me, gentlemen, crowd.
As you're standing there looking around...
I try to stop him.
Man walks up to you guys. He's young, tall, with unruly brown hair, which is different than a lot of the other... random people around that are shorter and have like really close cropped hair. He's dressed in Western clothes, bowing and speaking in flawless English. Good day to you and welcome to Egypt. My name is Ibi Musa. If you have yet to arrange your accommodation, may I suggest the Hotel du Sud? Please, permit me to take care of your luggage for you. And...
No. As no, before you can I won't let him.
A group sir, of... No,
sir, please.
Boys, we don't need your sir. And grab your please. Bags.
No.
And you can try to pull away from them. At a hard dex.
Hard dex?
Hard dex rolls.
Oh, fuck.
I would like to...
Why? Talk.
Wow.
Can I pull a vial from my alchemy portable set, my chemistry portable set, a vial that if I open it, it's basically like a sedative. I wave it in his face and I snap the tip of the vial and release the soothing chemicals.
Yes!
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Igor, I will say that you can, but you have to let go of your bag to do it.
And okay. after I manage to get away, hey, I pull out my gun. Step away from my friends and lift
up. Let
the bags alone. Step away.
As you get pull the- out your gun, all of the police officers that are on the docks pull out their weapons and take aim at you. Doctor, and you realize there are easily 50 police officers.
They are stealing our bags, police.
It doesn't
We're not stealing bags. We're just offering to take their luggage to the hotel.
You are stealing our bags.
We are not stealing
your bags. Get away! Get them down, put them on the ground. And leave us.
All the bags are lower, put on the ground, and the boys start to step back. But Ibi Musa is just standing there with his arms raised. We mean no harm. These Americans.
I said I refuse your service, so, and you still continue to try to rob us. Get
we
lost.
Are not trying to rob you. We were taking your bags to the hotel.
I don't care. We didn't ask you for this. Leave us. Doctor alone. Stop,
please stop by lowering your gun. If you haven't noticed, the policemen around us are all taking aim at you. Please.
So, how can I make him have sweet dreams? Do I roll a chemistry? A science chemistry?
You're so still going for it, god damn it.
Just make a dex roll to see
if
you
can they are trying to... Policers? Okay. Do I actually realize that they are aiming at me?
All the police are aiming at you and there is one approaching you with his rifle raised.
Approaching
you? As...
Sir,
you release the...
Yes.
As you basically
sir,
poison
to,
a child...
They try to rob us, I...
You're
I
able to,
scare them.
One of
I
the boys
put,
collapses.
I will put the gun slowly down, sir. It's okay. Hey. And I start slowly put the gun down. On the ground, and I put it on the ground, and I have my arms raised. I have doclets from that gun. I use my real... My gun that I own. I blow that one.
The officer who's approaching you grabs your guns and
I then
confiscates it.
I can show you my doclets. This is I have doclets from for that gun.
That's nice.
I have to excuse myself for my partner here. He was a veteran in the Great War, and since then he's anxious about someone following him. That's why he's carrying on just out of security, and that's why he got so over himself. Please excuse us.
Also, I obviously told them to leave us alone and stay still. They'll go try to. and they still grab our bags.
I can never hear the last part of what you say.
It was.
I think you're not using the push to talk button all the way, because I can never hear the last part of what you say.
Do you guys hear me okay? Or
right now I hear completely. Yes.
I didn't hear anything after or.
Oh, okay. I will.
There again.
That's probably just me.
I didn't
that's just
hear
me.
Anything.
Sir, they obviously tried to rob us. I just tried to scare them off. I didn't mean any harm.
I don't think they meant any harm. They were just doing what they do, hoping to get paid.
I don't. I said them that I refuse. That I don't want them to take my things.
We told him no, and he tried to take our baggage by force.
Yes.
In where we come from, we call that assault and robbery, or attempted robbery.
You should at least go to the Hotel du Sud and see if it's a real place. Or if it was just some alley they were trying to draw you to.
Perhaps you could show us the way or find somebody that you trust to take us there.
That man was already headed there? Have him take you.
It seems like we have to learn a lot about Egyptian cultures. All right. You know what? I'm actually pretty tired of this journey towards Egypt. I really just wanted to see the next best hotel, and right after that, I need to look for a culture book of Egypt, or else I won't get used to this. Apparently, this is an everyday case of, and it's treated like it's being normal around here.
Yeah, I agree. This is. It was
not America.
True.
Yes.
I'm very sorry about that. We should have informed ourselves a bit earlier. Yeah, in any case, if you excuse us, and if you know we are not up to any harm, we are now wishing to continue to our search for a hotel.
Yes.
Police officer hands Dr. Granum his gun back.
Thank you. And I put it back in my belt.
Yes, you can.
Older.
Officers.
As you're there, Ibn Musa walks back up and says, "The Hotel du Sud has rooms open."
I just tiredly looking at him. I'm sorry, we do not want your services. Please.
If you insist, Madame Patelnad will be very upset. And he lowers his hands and turns away, starts to walk back into the crowd.
By the way, I think this caused a bit of uproar. How did the crowd behave during, the almost gunshot?
People were panicking.
Alright.
Well, we can kiss secrecy goodbye by now. Whoever would be looking for us definitely knows where we are now. Perhaps it's even they're even looking at us.
Oh, almost certainly, but I gotta be honest with you, Mr. Petrovsky. After the events in New York and London, I lost. I don't want to say I lost care to that, but it's almost like that.
Let's just. Actually, Arkhart, what's the? Is there like? Is the crowd again, or what's up? How does it look like? No.
There's still the crowd of people. They're trying to get travelers to different hotels, hire them for their services, whatever they can get for a day or two.
Oh, okay. Guys, we should get our things at our hands, so I'll keep them at our hands, so we won't risk us getting robbed. Let's put our backpacks in front so we can keep our eye on them. And I get my backpack and I put it backwards on my belly.
Okay.
So. And I put everything that I have, like in my pockets, everything I put it into the backpack. And I'm holding the backpacks strongly. At least with all the time, at least with one hand, all the time.
Alright. As you guys move away from the docks, you're able to get through the crowd. A few people look at you kind of cautiously, but nobody seems to be paying any of you a lot of extra attention other than your troublesome foreigners. But everyone in the crowd is, they have their own. What they're trying to do, they're trying to hire themselves out. And after, a minute or two, you're able to get through the crowd and just walk into the streets. You are able to get a ticket for a train to take you into Cairo the next day.
Okay, can we get a hotel that's not too much in the city, we will try to look for a hotel that's not too to the center.
Okay.
Something, yeah. Where there are not that much people, or area that there are not too much people.
Okay, you can make luck rolls.
Of course.
See if you can find one.
Of course.
Hello again.
Of course. Luck rolls! He goes save us! Yes! He goes for the save.
Your friendly neighborhood Russian.
Igor, while you try to go off to the left, everybody else seems to be drifting over to the right of the city, and you come to a hotel that's a little dilapidated looking, but it seems to have been at least somewhat cleaned out exterior-wise recently.
Hey, gentlemen, I have a good feeling about this one.
And you see a sign that says Hotel du Sud.
Okay, I can come to him.
Sure.
This one looks more shady, I don't know. I think we might get some respite from the heat.
You're inside, the lobby is decorated in a style that has long gone out of taste. And there is a slender middle-aged woman of European descent behind a reception desk. She is elegant, with good quality clothes on, and she's wearing she has sandy brown hair, which she keeps in a tight bun. She's wearing a pair of glasses on the bridge of her nose, and she smiles, speaking French. She says, "Bonjour," as soon as you walk in.
Bonjour, madame.
speak French, Igor?
Just a little bit.
Alright.
Okay. Before the Bolsheviks took over, the Russians were very, very into French culture, and the Tsar and his family, they spoke French during breakfast in their home. I mean, the Tsarist family, the royal family, mm-hmm. and the nobles were speaking French on a daily day on a day to day basis. I mean, they were pretending they were French, mostly.
I also have... I also speak French. I just learned it somewhere. I don't remember this point.
Alright, the woman looks at you and says, English! Travelers?
I talked to her French and said that, greetings. It's fine. I know French, sort of. No. I don't speak French too often. And now we would love to get a rooms at this hotel for us for the night.
Oh, of course. You are honored guests. I am Madame Petenard. I manage the hotel. Please, I will show you to your rooms.
Enchanté, madame.
I'm not trying to be charmed. I'm just sort of normal, like not rude. Well, it's just normal behavior. Overdoing it like Harold and Igor. Did I obviously see them drink?
Alright. She, despite the hotel, the cost of the rooms, which she tells you, and they're very inexpensive rooms, the hotel is not very prosperous. There's no other, all the rooms are vacant by appearance.
I mean, it's fine. Is there a room that is for four people?
Madame Petenard says, oh, I'm sorry, dear. Individual rooms only.
Oh, okay. And that's fine.
She shows you two rooms that are not adjacent to each other. They're just, you know, your room, an empty room, your room, an empty room.
Okay.
The rooms are, they look tired. And as dilapidated as the rest of the hotel, although they are clean. Apart from the bed and washstand in each room, there's not much in the way of furniture other than an old wicker chair, a large wardrobe, a chest of drawers, and a small bedside table with a very battered electric lamp sitting on it.
I think that's fine. It's better than nothing, at least.
If I can get you anything else while you're here, please do not hesitate to ask.
Whiskey.
Oh, of course. Whiskey. And she disappears, leaving you all into your individual rooms.
Yeah.
She brings a bottle of whiskey.
Also, I would say that we would require... did we get the keys from our rooms?
Yes. Oh, she gave you keys and everything.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, I was...
While we are visiting the rooms, could I get a glimpse of how the rooms are protected?
Yeah, is there a window in our rooms, actually?
Either a window or a protected door.
There's a small window in each room that looks over, like, on to alleys and the street and stuff. not big enough for a person to climb through. More just to look out of and get some air ventilation in.
Is there a cover for the window or door?
Yeah.
How about the door?
Door is just simple, you know, a couple inches thick, cheap wood.
Okay.
Okay, except for the keyhole, there's nothing else that protects it.
Nope.
Is there... How much the shells and tables, how close to are the towers?
The wardrobe is along, like, if you were standing in the door, across from you was the window to the left, in most rooms is the bed, to the right is the wardrobe. Next to the bed are the small tables and the chairs. And then they're either flipped, depending on what side of the hotel you're on.
Okay. Could it be... So the wardrobe would be the best to move if needed. Okay. Not saying it.
Just wedge the chair under the door handle.
When we expect, going through the rooms, I just a little bit touch the chair to see how stable it is.
It's decently stable.
Huh. I'm surprised it didn't break out. Or when I would touch it.
Okay,
Can I make a sleep gas trap?
Oh my goodness.
I don't want unexpected visitors during the night.
Yeah.
I mean, it's reasonable for Igor to do that.
Are you hooking up somewhere near the door?
And the window.
One in the door and one for the window, okay. Make an intelligence roll.
Damn.
Oh no.
Actually, I was just looking for your rolled amount to see if someone was to try to get in, if they'd be able to resist. If they'd be able to notice the trap or not.
Yeah.
Shit. Alright, I think we meet up after we got our stuff into our rooms. I think we all lock the door, and if we meet up after that, I'm gonna repeat myself again and say, I don't know what you guys do, but I'm looking for a library now. Need to do some research about Egyptian cartoons. Yeah,
and you shouldn't go. You shouldn't go alone.
I really shouldn't. No, no.
I would like to come with too.
All right.
But someone should stay. Look out for our rooms. If someone tried to take peek.
Well, I'm unarmed. I don't see how I could help in that situation.
Well, we could always leave Jack on guard.
He's just patrolling the floor.
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay, good.
And I'll go and have a word with the owner and ask
the lady.
Get to Cairo by is there a direct train?
Yes, it's a direct train.
Didn't we get the train actually already?
Yep, you guys were able to get a train ticket. As part of your ticket for the boat passage, it included train travel.
Oh, okay.
So from the port city to Cairo.
Alright. whoever follows me now, I'll go to the reception first and try to ask the person there where the next library or yeah, and any kind of bookstore would be to inform myself about Egyptian culture.
You get down, when you look in the lobby, there is a man there. He's looks like he's reading a newspaper of some sort. Mm-hmm. Not really paying attention to you until you walk right up to the reception desk. He looks up with a smile. He's got a couple missing teeth. And he looks tired. Yes?
Right. Excuse me, sir. I am looking for some kind of library in this city. Would you know of some?
There's no library here.
Okay, and any kind of bookstore where I could find some Egyptian guideline for travelers or for foreigners?
Oh, thought when you said bookstore, you were looking wanting some of those naughty magazines, if you know what I'm saying. But if you want to know about Egyptian culture, you could just ask me.
Alright, fine. Where should I start? Let's start first about the persons in the city who want to carry our packs. What we bring here to the hotel. Are they for real or are they robbers? Because in our country, those people would be considered robbers because they always have the intention to rob people. Is that too different?
Dragomen. Most of them are reputable. They either work for a hotel, some of them are private, you know. They will carry your luggage for you when you go to a hotel or from one hotel to another.
So it's perfectly normal.
Yes. There are some that are disreputable and give the others a bad name, but most can be counted on to.
Do you know one named Ibn Musa?
Oh, Ibi, yes. Ibi works for a hotel.
Well, if you meet Mr. Musa, a second question. Is Musa the sir or the last name?
Ibi Busa.
Busa, sorry. Alright. If you see him again, could you tell him the weird foreigners from today were sorry?
Oh, of course. You know, he won't be back probably until the morning.
Okay, if you see him again, please get it to him. I'm really, really sorry. There was a misunderstanding of how it was said. I don't want to say a cultural clash about the culture of America and Egypt collided in an incident. It didn't work out very well, and this person was included in that somehow.
Yes.
Yeah. If you would get that to him, I would highly appreciate it.
Of course.
Okay. Next, Doctor, did you had a question?
No. Let's not.
Mr. Petrovsky?
I'm sorry. What did you say?
If you had any question on Egyptian culture, because I mean, there are a lot of things different in America, and when we run to, were they called again? A passage? The one who carry the carriage?
Do I use a library use? Do I roll library use?
No.
No, you're talking to the guy on reception at the hotel.
He said that something like a library doesn't apparently exist in Egypt?
No. I wouldn't say, it's more like they don't have one in this city. I would say more like.
I guess I wouldn't have any general questions about the Egyptian culture. I mean, What's the point? I know what everybody knows about the pharaohs, the traps, the pyramids, their mythology, bits and pieces of history and mythology.
Yeah, the thing is, Doctor, the pharaohs were 3,000 years ago, at least.
And you didn't say nothing.
What?
What?
Okay, that was weird. Different one.
So, Harold,
you said doctor, and you thought you were talking to him because you said doctor. I'm not a doctor, I'm a PhD in chemistry.
Okay.
I don't teach at the university. You wouldn't call me a doctor, I think. I don't know, really.
Okay, that's pretty weird, but on an out of character level. another question I would have. Another question I would have would be. We talked to two policemen, and they told us that bargaining seems to be a big deal here around Egypt. Why is that so?
It's just the way of the world.
Yeah, sure, but you wouldn't see a policeman in New York telling you to bargain. I only experienced that here in Egypt.
In Egypt,
is there something special?
Bargaining is part of the way we do things.
So there are no set prices. You have to bargain about.
Well, there's a set price that is advertised, and there is a price that something will be sold for. They are not often the same thing.
Okay, that's quite interesting to know.
If you give them their asking price, they will be glad for the money, but they will eventually be disappointed because they enjoy bartering and testing their merchant skills on you. It disappoints and even insults them a bit if you give them their initially asked price. You have to barter with them, otherwise it's kind of rude.
Okay, there are a lot of things different here. another question. What are some topics you shouldn't talk to the everyday Egyptian person?
I'll just put it this way. You're American, I'm guessing, by your accent.
At least I am.
I'm not American.
Me neither.
You're English, though.
Close enough.
You can play your foreigner cards. You can ask anything, and if it offends somebody, say that you're a foreigner and you didn't know it any better.
Okay.
But just to be on the safe side, what shouldn't we ever ask or say or do?
Don't do anything that would upset Allah.
Oh, okay.
I see.
It's a fair point. Alright, do you have any questions left, you three?
Well, I would like to ask him if he knows when the next trains are to Cairo.
Oh, I think the trains depart at dawn. But I could be wrong.
Right.
The trains leave when the trains leave.
Oh, where would I find clothes that are, well, if you see myself, I look like the average tourist guide, walking around. Is there a shop somewhere, where you could, dress up to not raise, much attention in the crowd?
First, no, That sounds so creepy.
It shouldn't sound creepy if you
agree.
I'm
not dressing like these barbarians. No way.
Barbarians.
Igor, goddamn it!
Mr. Petrovsky, please, language.
I don't say that out loud,
telepathic.
So the other guy can hear me. I just say that to my traveling companions.
We don't have telekinesis. No, wait, that's the wrong thing. We cannot read minds. But you can whisper to us that, sure. Whatever, okay.
So certainly
I just say what he was mentioning is that he wants to try to deculture dress. He thinks it's a you have really nice culture and dresses, and he would like to try one. And I actually would also like to try one.
Oh,
trying new things.
You could probably find there are stores around you can easily get.
Is there one locally that you would recommend? Possibly run by your brother or a cousin?
If you knew my cousin, you would not want to go to a store of his.
Okay.
You could go to there's a store down the street. If you take a left out here and go down, they sell clothes.
Thanks.
Thank you.
And remember to barter.
Yeah, I remember that. Think about that. Okay. With Mr. Boussard to get him that message.
And of looking course. On the bright side, if you're wearing local dress, you're probably less likely to get pickpocketed. And also any weapons that you're carrying are less likely to be spotted.
Rude and weird, but okay. Guys. Sorry, we didn't mean to be rude.
You guys would know that Egyptian dress and like jewelry and stuff is very fashionable in many parts of the world. So having clothes from Egypt is not wouldn't be considered strange.
Is there?
Where can I find some mouse traps?
Okay.
Mouse traps or rat traps?
Mouse traps.
Both. For the little problems and for the big problems.
For the kind of problems that I mean, the bigger
window and door.
As
the
big
bigger rats.
As big as can fit in my coat pocket.
Sure, I'll say yes. You can.
Too specific, Igor. Too specific.
I want to have surprises for pickpocketers.
I'll say yes. You can find someone who is willing to sell you mouse traps.
Just be careful which way you put put them in your trouser pocket. You don't want anything unfortunate to get caught in them.
No, it's not for the trousers, it's for the coat.
Jeez. Great. Fucking great.
Alright. Okay then. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, goodbye.
Alright, you guys are able to go and get clothes.
He thinks we are weird assholes. Probably.
Yeah.
No, we're foreigners.
That's the same thing, though. Almost.
Yeah, by definition.
You just say it nicely.
Oh,
yeah.
Cool. Nice. That's cool.
You're able to get clothes. And I'm going to assume you're able to talk the price down a little bit. Probably, you guess somewhere around 20% of the price getting cheaper. Before the sun sets and you start heading back to the hotel.
Yeah, I would actually let him get a better price at one point, just to be nice.
Okay.
Like, actually, yeah. Just to be nice, like, yeah.
I wasn't gonna run the, have you guys roleplay the shopping portion. So I'm just gonna assume that you're able to do it successfully.
Let's just say yes.
Yeah.
We got some nice clothes. Yeah.
Though it would be fun to see, turning the price down and still paying 10 times more than the normal value.
That actually may have been the case for us at some point. I wouldn't be surprised. Or mad. It's just not sure for Egypt.
At least you can say you got some nice souvenirs from Egypt.
Hmm. Yeah, that's nice, but engraving doesn't help us.
Alright, as you get back to the hotel, you
and go... Didn't we want to go to the shop, the bookshop, yeah?
He didn't tell you about any bookshop.
You could always ask the guy.
Do we look for one? Do we wanna look for one, guys?
As I asked him about bookshop, he mentions the the ones pastors rarely read.
Oh, you mean porn? Okay.
Yeah, that one.
Okay. That's
okay.
What did you expect?
I'm assuming we can buy all the hashish you can smoke or eat or whatever because it's legal. I mean, it was legal back in the West during those times, I think.
Sure, there was no law against it, so...
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm gonna, I'll say that, sure, you can buy anything legal.
Alright, we should buy guns later on, that's true. Yeah, we can do that at some point, but not now. Not in this town. This town is too big, right?
No, trust me, it's going to be useful someday. I'm not saying we should do this now, but it's going to be turn out very useful to have that.
Yes. Us.
Okay. And don't mind that roll. Mind that.
Okay, okay, if that's the case for the books, then we just go to the hotel.
Alright. As you settle in your individual rooms, darkness is ending. It is still extremely hot outside.
Yeah, right. Funny thing, I get the wardrobe to block the doors.
I need you all to make listen rolls.
Hooray. 48 score. What could go wrong? Huh, nothing.
What the fuck?
Alright.
That's interesting.
I know, right?
Igor, you're the only one who doesn't hear this, strange, like, grinding sound. It's like a panel moving. But everyone else, even though you're, like, drowsing and ready to sleep, you hear it, and you're instantly awake. Although your rooms are dark, you're hearing this noise, and you start looking around. So you can make...
In my room, I'd like to turn on the flashlight.
Okay.
I have.
Make a... Listen, spot hidden rolls, everybody.
Except for me, because I'm sleeping. Right?
Except for you. Yeah, except for Igor.
Yeah, what about me?
I was going to say you didn't have to be hard.
That's depressing.
Alright, Dr. Gunnum, you're looking around, but you're not entirely sure. None of you are able to actually see where the sun is coming from. But it's all... It was enough to wake you up. And alert you.
Actually, a question. Do I have light in my room? Like... lamp or something like that?
There is a lamp. On your bed.
Okay. Yeah, I will turn it on and look around. And also, I would have a gun under my pillow.
Okay.
So I get it. So I also have a gun in my hands.
I need you and Dr. Gannon to make a dex roll.
Oh, fuck.
Wow, alright. As your hand, like, flies over to the lamp and you hit the switch, the room is bathed in light, and you see the wardrobe door as open, and there is a short person dressed all in black standing by your bags as though he was about to go through them when the light snapped on.
I have my gun and I am with him.
He looks up and raises his hands. Please don't shoot, don't shoot, don't shoot, don't shoot!
I just look at him like, how the hell did you get in?
He looks back and forth. He realizes that you've barricaded the door with the chair.
No, I barricaded it with the wardrobe.
Oh, you used the wardrobe was secured to the wall. You couldn't move the wardrobe.
Oh, okay. Then I will use anything needed. Okay, chair.
The small reading table moved. Would have been able to move without problems.
Yeah, I would use probably most of them to barricade it. So it's annoying to get in here.
The thief looks at the door, realizes he can't make his escape that way, and turns and he runs toward the wardrobe, jumping through the open door, reaching for a panel in the back of the wardrobe, sliding into the side, and jumping through.
What the? I quickly go look.
The back of the wardrobe is a false back, and it leads right into the next room.
Which would be?
It's an empty room.
It's just okay. That's Eve! I yelled.
Alright, everybody else can make a listen roll.
And I go, and I start running to Bihar. And I start chasing him. Start chasing him.
Alright. Joseph, you hear the cry of thief. And you wake up. And as your eyes slowly adjust to darkness, you realize there is somebody in your room going through your bags.
Flashlight. Right into his eyes.
The thief looks up. He's got something in his hand.
I stand up and look at it from the distance. What is it?
It looks like a small bundled up book.
You! Lay that down!
He's going to choke us with it while we sleep.
The thief looks at the door and then runs right for the wardrobe.
And I'm trying to tackle him before he can do that.
Alright, make a dex roll.
Did I manage to catch up on thief? Do I see him? Do I see him?
You don't see where the thief was that was in your room.
I very quickly go follow him.
Alright. Joseph, you're able to tackle the thief.
You get down here!
And Doctor!
Dr. Igor! Hello!
What?
I try to run through to get the thief, the other one.
I bull rush my room.
In my room.
Alright, Harold and Igor, as you wake up and look, there, your bags have been torn apart, and your possessions have been rifled through, and looks like stuff has been stolen.
I try to bull rush the thief.
There's no thief in your room anymore. The thief that had been in your room is already gone.
Then I didn't know we have separate rooms. Okay, yep. So I immediately, as soon as I realized I've been robbed, or at least somebody went through my stuff, I go to the other room, screaming, waking everybody up if they're still sleeping, and say, "We've been robbed! Get up! We've been robbed! Thieves!" Okay. And I barge into the other room. Do I still see the thieves?
The only thief you see is the one that Joseph has tackled.
And did I manage to... When I quickly start running, I get like for him, for the thief that was in my room.
You can make a dex check to see if you're able to chase him.
Roll a dexterity, right?
Yep.
Cool.
You catch up to the thief as he's on the stairs, and you grab him.
I have the pistol. Oh, you have it close.
Don't shoot!
On the ground. You're coming with me. And
get him to my room, doctor.
I'm helping him.
I'm getting him to the room with. The pastor, okay. Yeah. I am keeping the gun behind him so he doesn't grab it.
Okay.
And I get my other hand. I have other hand around his neck.
Okay. You guys all meet up in one room, in Joseph's room, and. You know, with the two thieves, you look at them, and they are two of the boys who had been at the dock, who had tried to grab your bags.
I knew it.
Please don't shoot!
For the time being, we should gag them, and tie them up.
Yeah.
Try them out.
Harold, tie them. I'm aiming at them. Don't try anything stupid.
And I search them for tattoos, but first I want to go through their pockets and empty them. I want to check their sleeves and their pants.
Alright,
for concealed lockpicks or blades or anything.
You can make a spot hidden roll.
Judging by their appearance, how old are they?
Judging by their appearance, you'd guess them to be something, they'd be young, less than 10.
Ouch.
Igor, while you're searching, you find that each one of the thieves, they're carrying short knives that are old and probably very weak.
Oh, well, what do we have here? This will break your mother's heart, young man.
The thieves are just looking at each other. They don't say anything.
Huh.
I get the feeling they don't understand us. They don't. They can't. They can just speak. Can I help you? And please don't shoot. Apparently.
Maybe.
This will make questioning them rather difficult.
Okay. Need to tie them. We need. Bite them and call the police.
I think we can handle a bunch of small boys. Let's just bring them down to the lobby and call the police.
Also,
I'd like to try something.
There could be another way.
Joseph kneels down, so he's he can look both of the boys in, into the eyes, and tries to sound intimidant, and asking, "Do you understand me?"
The boys just look at each other and shake their heads.
He's going to shoot you.
That's not a good way to approach
it. Is there any reaction from the boys when I say that?
The boys look at each other and then they shake their head. They don't understand what's being said.
Oh. How cute. It would be a shame if my... I'm being full cut them.
I'm tempted to put the blade of the knives on the floor and break them.
No, okay. Don't break them.
Why?
We might need them to show them the hotel personnel, to show them that we're not just kidnapping some boys.
The hotel person is in league with them. Sliding panels in the wardrobes and with empty rooms in between us.
That's true. That's a good point. Yes.
I'd be against the idea, but I can't stop you.
Well, the main thing is that it will just probably hurt the boys by them losing their knives.
But I won't get them to talk.
They can't talk.
Well, if they only speak Egyptian, then we're not going to be able to get them to speak anyway.
I try something. I try to speak to them French.
Okay.
Do you understand me?
The boys look at each other and look back at you. Don't say anything.
Well, they don't shake their heads.
Do they like shake they don't understand or just don't say anything?
They just don't say anything. They look confused.
Like confused that actually someone speaks the language, or confused because they don't understand anything?
Confused as though people are speaking to them but they don't know what's being said.
Of course.
Although, at this point, you guys can all make intelligence rolls. Alright. You guys would guess, aside from Joseph, you would guess that since Islam is the most dominant religion, you would guess that Arabic is the most prominent language.
Oh, great.
Nobody speaks that, right?
Probably the receptionist.
You mentioned something about a book my thief was holding. Which one was it?
Let's see. You're going to...
I have 5 books, 4 of them occult or mythos related.
Okay, I need you to then roll 1d5.
Okay, seems fair to me. The Bible, okay.
Yep. As soon as the thief just reached in and grabbed whatever they found first.
Okay,
Are they tied up and gagged, or are just tied up?
They're so far just tied up.
Okay, I will check. I will go and check my rooms and give the pistol to Harold.
Okay.
I will check our rooms and get my stuff to this room.
I go back to my room and check everything. Am I missing any items?
Igor, when you look in your what's left of your bag, since you had noticed the thief, they had a chance to rummage through everything and they stole all the money that you had in your bag.
They stole all my money, little rascals. Well, at least I have my chemistry set.
What's in the canister?
gentlemen. Did someone...
I go to my room, get out... I go to my room, get all my things into the main room, to the room where Buster is with the kids. I lay it on the, I get the stuff on the bed and go to the room of Harold and yeah, and see what they lost, what Harold and Igor lost. So what did they stole from you, Igor?
They stole all my money, the little devils.
Ah, damn it. What an annoyance. I knew I cannot, they cannot be trusted, I knew it. Or also it could be that we didn't let them. But still, I don't trust them. They might have just stole it and run away.
I think we should try aiding the employing the help of the receptionist here, because none of us
is she is working with them. Look at the wardrobes.
No.
This is planned.
If she did, I think she would have hired competent help.
I mean,
indeed. Also, if you take a look at it, the kids don't work for her. The kids work in quotation marks with Busa was his name. Yeah, with Busa.
Still, she could know about it and agreed to it.
I get your trust issues. I get them, really.
Then we are left with the police.
It's, they can play it out though. That's the problem. They probably be like, they try to attack these children, they're innocent, and blah blah.
Why would we attack them? How would they end up in our rooms if we attack them? But if we were to be discovered right now, with them tied up like this, it would look really bad. So I say we untie them, bring them down to the reception. I think we can manhandle a bunch of boys and call for the police.
Considering our situation that today is the day of our train going to Cairo, the inner city of Cairo. I gotta be honest with you, Dr. Mr. Petrovsky's opinion about how we should handle the boy situation is the only viable option right now.
I would suggest we try to elicit the help of the receptionist. She should know Arabic and she might translate for us.
And I don't trust her. What if she?
I get your point, Doctor. But what else do you have in mind? Do you want to learn Arabic in the next 1 hour?
Did we see a bathroom somewhere in the hotel?
No, you're not trying to bother both of them, aren't you?
However, I think we would learn little from her translating, acting as a translator between us and the boys. They're just a bunch of scoundrels stealing for their boss, their criminal organization, or whatever they do.
No, how could you think that? I'm just gonna kill them, that's all.
They're just a couple of gutter snipes, that's all. There's not much we can learn from them. If they were assassins, I'm assuming they would have had a sign or a tattoo or some nonsense like that.
Well, just a question right now. While Igor was searching their pocket, was there anything unusual about their skin, like having some kind of signs or symbols on them?
No.
No.
So they have on themselves only the knives, nothing else, okay.
Excuse me for one moment, gentlemen.
I don't know. I hate this, but you're right. We need to go to... the female and tell her about this. This is all the best solution. And for the night, when we gonna get this, we...
Back. Sorry about that.
We gonna need to deal with the pet wardrobe somehow.
So, what did we decide?
We're gonna untie them, and I'm gonna get my gun. Or my pistol holder. But I'm holding one of them strongly, so he doesn't run away. Not like it does look weird, like aggressive. I try to be natural, but still grabbing him hard that he doesn't escape so easily.
Okay. You are able to walk the thieves downstairs to the lobby, and you see Madame Patine talking to somebody.
Also, we would leave Jack and Harold. Are you here? Okay.
Also, sorry, keep fading out.
Harold, can you? What the fuck? I don't understand. Harold, could you stay upstairs and keep eye on our items while we go downstairs?
Yep. Did we recover everything that the boys took?
They took Igor's money. What did they steal from you?
Harold, they also stole all the money you had.
Right, and did they have it on them when we when they were caught?
You didn't catch the thieves that had stolen from you or Igor.
There was four of them.
So how did they get down the corridor when without us seeing them?
You don't know, but they managed to escape.
I think they used the windows. They may have come in through the window. Or at least...
The wardrobe was openable on the other side.
The wardrobe?
Yeah.
Yes, the wardrobe's in all of the rooms.
Alright. How did they do that? I mean... kind of double doors.
Yes, it's double doors. You can see. Nice. So it's visible, right? In my room? Or...
Okay, could you show that to me?
Yeah, I show it in my room. It's probably still open, right?
Mm-hmm.
This was a setup, indeed. I know your doubts, Doctor. Something like that exists.
When you bring the thieves to Madame Patineau, she looks up at you, in shock. What is going on?
These boys tried to rob us, and so there were four of them. Some of them actually robbed my partners.
We managed to get... I can't believe that.
Also, we do have some questions for you, Madame. If you're free right now,
of course, yes.
Can you go upstairs with us?
We want to show you something.
Oh, okay.
As we go upstairs, I ask her how long has she been working here.
Oh, years.
Are you the owner of this hotel?
Yes. Well, and my parents were the owners before me.
How long have you been the owner of this hotel?
Well, probably 10-15 years.
And who do you know who the owners were before that?
My parents.
Family business, so...
She knows how this place is built.
Would you know how this building was made? Were you alive when your parents raised this hotel?
Yes. I was a child, but yes.
Okay.
Okay, then you know that... And just for clarification before we arrive at our rooms, the rooms are
divided from each other, so yes. You do not enter a room from one room to another without entering by, correct?
Correct.
Okay, then we continue on to the doctor's room. Could you take a look at the wardrobe? I guess the wardrobe was closed, the double door.
Can you explain this?
And now, the lever, I pull the lever and the double door should open.
What? What has been done to my hotel? Oh!
Psychology, can I roll for the psychology?
Yeah, of course you can.
But I think I...
Why? Why?
She's standing there. Dr. Grant, you don't believe a word she says.
Oh,
interesting.
How cute.
That's
crazy. Okay, you will. Okay, but we are gonna call
the police. What was done to the walls of my hotel?
I don't believe you.
We did not do anything. We are just some travelers which arrived yesterday, and judging by how this room looks, I'm not a carpenter or a roommaker or anything, but this room has been like this since it was built.
That makes no sense.
It makes no sense to me either.
Yeah, but you're lying. You can stop trying lying. It's obvious. You're bad at this.
No. I'm really shocked.
Ha ha, very funny. Harold, can you come to us and make sure that she understands we mean business? Harold, can you understand me? Guys, do you understand me?
Yeah, we understand you.
I can.
It seems like Harold is timing out again for a short time.
Yeah. Damn.
Yeah. He should be back in a minute or so.
Wait here. I'm gonna get something. I'm gonna quickly go to the Harold road and get to the gun and come back. Oh, there it is. Now.
Do I see the gun?
No, please.
Do I see it? Do I see the gun before the doctor gets inside of the hotel owner?
I don't know. It depends on if he's hiding it or not.
Are you hiding it?
I'm not hiding it.
I'm standing in front of him and trying to cover the gun.
Are you insane?
No, I want to make sure that we meant business.
Doctor, please listen to me. If you show her that gun, she will get even more stressed and she won't answer our questions.
What is going on? I don't know what's going on here.
Fine, for now.
I don't see her lying, but if you really believe she is lying...
She is lying, trust me.
If she's lying, you have to find that out through smart questioning, not through violence.
I wasn't gonna violent, I'm just gonna threaten
her. You were pulling up a gun against her. I consider that a threat, like a literal threat, with killing intention.
Fine, I hide my pistol in my pistol holder and make sure that it's not visible.
Thank you.
All right. Now, okay then. Now, you're not making this easier. Please, we know that you are lying. You literally just tell us that you saw it to building us, and it is family business after all, so... No. We gonna need the money back. That's... Yeah.
That's the first part.
Yes.
The second part is... even though it shouldn't be our business now, it is, because we are affected directly. I'd really like to know why there is a
perfectly made hole for that wardrobe here, which leads into the other room with no markings left, which lead to the assumption that it was made recently. Judging from that, and if the doctor is telling the truth, it would appear to me that while you said the truth, that you know everything about the hotel since your parents raised it, you lied to us that you didn't know about this hole. So I really like to know why you would do such thing.
To get money, really, of course.
Are you really supporting criminality like that?
I didn't know what was going on. You must believe me.
I don't believe you.
Look, I really do want to believe you, but evidence speaks for itself.
Oh, we don't need to call the police, we just want the money back. So, Igor, call Harold, can you tell me how much was it?
Yes.
How much did you have?
I actually don't know.
Also, it's you can stop lying now. It's obvious for us now that those holes were made intentionally for robbers to get into the rooms of foreigners easily without opening the door or anything. My question would be, why would you give us these rooms? Why? What was your intention? I really don't get it. Maybe because I'm American.
Money. It's always money.
It's always money, yeah, but it can't be that her parents planned that just because of money. Did your parents...
Good question. I actually don't care. I just want my money back. I just want Eagles and the Herald's money to get them, to be given back to them, so... Can you show us where you hold the money and pay us back?
Are you gonna rob me?
No!
No, we are gonna get... We are just gonna get our things. Our money that you stole from us. And by I mean through these little boys, which is horrible.
Look, I tell you something. In your lifetime, you often get to choose between two pathways. Now, there is a situation for this. You can go one way, giving us our money back, and we won't tell anyone. It's balanced out, as you might say. Or you go the other way. You keep pretending you didn't know about this. We do not get our money back. You dishonor your family. You dishonor your entire ancestors. And probably you will be arrested. Most likely you will be arrested. I don't believe Egyptian laws are different from ours. So, what person are you? What pathway do you choose?
When he starts talking like that, I go to the doors and be standing close to them so I can block the doors. If she tries to run, I'm ready to grab her.
Okay. Where are the thieves? I will ask them how much they stole.
The thieves should be in the hallway if they didn't.
We would make sure that they are in the same room with us.
Okay, then they are with us.
Okay. Yeah, we let her talk to them, but I'm keeping eyes on her.
Alright, she starts speaking to the thieves in a language none of you understand.
Yeah.
Yes.
And the boys respond to her, and, you know, they have a brief conversation before she, Madame Pettinger, looks at and says, okay. They stole some. There was some money.
How much?
I can give you.
How much?
I'll pay you.
How much?
Okay.
7 pints.
Okay.
God damn it. But can I just say that that sounds like bullshit?
You can say that.
You can say it all you want.
I don't know if she's lying, but I don't believe that. Funny.
Should believe it because you failed your psychology role. So.
Very funny.
Dr. Herman Granum and Pastor Joseph would believe her.
No, I don't know.
Maybe not believe it, but they don't have anything against. So. Or anything that would say otherwise in that situation.
Wait.
Oh, come on.
Wow.
It's just like. Seriously. I might not know that she is lying, but. Well, what? Fuck it. I have so much.
Alright, you're back.
I have so little to luck that it doesn't matter.
Welcome back.
Yeah, I'm spending my luck.
It took a long time getting back home.
I spend my luck.
Okay. You have a absolute feeling that she should be paying you a lot more.
Yeah.
And she's trying to undercut you again.
Bullshit. That's
bargaining, Doctor. Bargaining.
I don't know. Fucking no. She stole from us. That's no.
You will give us the money now, all of it, or we go straight to the police.
Go to the police. I don't care.
Let's call the police then. Tell them that we have been robbed by our host.
While calling the police, Joseph is telling them, okay, so you choose the second path. Pathway of dishonor, discredibility, and shame.
And death. We could just shoot her and the two kids.
Maybe not. But all of the three I said.
I mean, here's the point.
I look her straight in the eye. Think about it. You now have a turning point. You can turn back now. You can be a good person again. Just give us the money back. We paid you for the services you did not... did not outwage your criminal activities.
We want all of the money that you stole from Igor and Harold back. All of it.
Think about it.
You can make have a fast talk.
Fast, not persuasion?
Or persuade, I'd say fast talk or persuade.
Okay, could I...
That's kind of nice.
Can I roll intimidate?
Are you intimidating her?
Sure, I don't, at this point... if I pull out a gun and start aiming at her, would that give me a bonus?
If you point your gun at her, yes, you'll have a, I'd say you have a bonus to it.
Yes, I pull out my gun and... Yeah, I intimate her. Get us the money or I'll shoot you!
Make your intimidate roll.
Yes!
Can someone please shut the door?
Okay.
Why? Why is persuasion being... I don't even have words for that.
I'm tired of this bullshit.
Fine. Okay.
And this... I'm coming with you.
£15 each. That's what I'll. I can pay back. I don't know where the thieves are. They don't come right to me.
Was it 15 pounds?
You would, if you had to guess, you'd think it was probably more. But she's not lying to you about the thieves not giving her the money right away.
It's more than 15 pounds, isn't it?
Yes. You can be sure of that. I think you should bargain for at least three times as much.
We are not bargaining. That's the thing. We are not.
Do your thing. You know what? Harold, Igor, whoever wants me, I want to go call the police.
I already did that. I was on my way to the police the entire time.
Okay, good. Then I stay up there and wait for your return.
So I'll be returning with the police as soon as I find them.
Okay. Igor, when you go to report the robbery, the police reluctantly come with you and reluctantly follow you back to the hotel. But they do come. And
Wait, can I roll listen?
Your enthusiasm is inspiring, officers.
No, okay, I will spend 4 luck. Okay, so that puts me in 5. I hear someone come.
You don't need to spend luck. I think I would hear them as well, so I can give you a sign to lower your gun.
Yeah, I will pull. When you told me that you hear, I will get my pistol to my holder, hide it.
Okay, doctor, they're coming.
Okay. Right this way, gentlemen.
All right. As soon as the officers, the couple police officers, walk in the door, Madame Patina starts shouting in Arabic.
Hey, calm down! Calm down!
Officers look at each other, look at her, look at you, and they draw their guns.
Whoa!
What did she tell you?
She's lying. Whatever she just told you, she's lying.
What did they tell you?
Put down your guns.
What did they tell you, officers?
Put down your guns.
I don't
raise your hands.
We don't have a gun. See?
I can see your gun right there. Put it down on the floor.
I hide it. Out of heart, I hide it. So it's not visible.
Sleight of hand in that case, I think.
Your gun. I can see you trying to hide it from me.
Doctor.
That's just my gun. Well, that I have on my own.
Lower it.
Put that on the floor.
I put it back into the pistol holder before they come. So I have it into pistol holder. Police, sir, I have the gun over here,
I didn't pull it out.
You keep interrupting, mate.
Put your hands above your head.
Okay, I have my hands above my head. I didn't do anything.
Officers, she is the one who stole from us. You're supposed to be arresting her, not us. We are the victims. We have been robbed.
Quiet, you.
What if we can prove it? What if we can prove it?
Quiet.
I will not stay quiet.
You want to come with us?
I require a lawyer from the United States.
Okay.
And I require the ambassador of the United States. It can't be that we are being treated like that, like we are being criminals.
We get the ambassador. I just promise you it will take between 2 to 3 months.
Oh, Christ.
I guess we need you guys to make a luck roll.
Oh, because it works so
I
well.
I have another idea. After this luck roll thing.
Yeah, this is obvious.
Okay.
It is my joy, it is so... It's... Yeah. Fuck off.
Let's see...
Like I said, I have the pistol holder and making sure that...
Okay. You can all make listen checks.
Wow.
This can't be.
Okay, at least some of us succeeded.
Harold, you hear very faint clicking of a gun cocking behind the police officers. And as you watch, Jack walks up to the door and he has a gun raised at the police officers.
And do I see this?
Yep.
Then I want to throw a concoction of mine in the midst of police officers that will make a cloud of choking smoke and concealing, like a smoke screen, a choking smoke screen.
Okay, make a throw check.
Don't do that.
I mean, just has to drop that.
Oh fuck, evil hit him. You just hit him! Fuck!
Mr. Dempsey, I'm really... Oh, what is that?
You go to throw... And it slips out of your hand at the last moment and drops right in front of you, and the cloud erupts right in front of your face.
Well, we still made some progress, at least they can't see well. At least we're concealed behind the smoke screen.
I point a finger towards the doctor, in the direction of Igor. I myself to Jack, to signalize the entire group that we are just taking them. I think all of them are affected by this smoke grenade, and we're just picking them up and then running out of sight as fast as we can.
Yes, I'm...
We can't do that. We'll leave all of our stuff behind. It's still upstairs.
The money... Yeah, well, we can't talk in this situation.
We can kill them.
I mean, we can, but... I would not appreciate that.
Do like I did. Just go with instinct. Go with your gut. Do the first thing that comes to mind.
No.
Be organic.
The Lord forbids me to kill. No.
I'm tired of this shit. I pull out my gun and start shooting at them.
Okay. Fuck which this. One are you? Which one are you shooting at? One on the left or one on the right?
I'm trying to shoot the one that is not behind that was not directly behind the Jack. Like I try to make sure that I don't hit the Jack.
Okay, so you're going for the one on the right. Make a attack roll.
Yeah. Okay, no this. God damn it, I hit at least once. It's broken. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, you you shoot the police officer in the shoulder. He cries out, and they begin shooting.
Yeah, I quickly run to my bag and try to pull out my other gun. And start shooting at them.
Joseph, in the meantime, points his flashlight against them, so their view will be affected. Maybe they get a penalty, or I don't know, something like that.
Alright, the officer
What about Jack?
Dr. Granum shot, immediately squeezes the trigger, and a bullet flies out and shoots Dr. Granum.
How much did I take?
And you take 6 points of damage.
Okay. Yeah, after I get hit, I try to grab my my Colt, and repeat the fire at him.
And Harold will draw and fire at the same one.
Okay.
Because I'm... I got just shot, that I'm probably able to just shoot 3 times.
Okay. Yeah, the first shot misses, but you're just fanning the pistol, and the other shots rip into the policeman's chest, and he falls to the ground.
I then try to get covered behind the bed. Okay. Awkwardly, but still.
Alright, Jack shoots the guy I'm standing right next to in the head for 9 damage.
And that, gross.
And the officer stumbles a little bit as he's bleeding out.
Where's the woman?
She's screaming hysterically.
When is my turn again?
You can go, you can go now.
I, throw a firebomb at them.
No!
Oh, for crying out loud.
No! It's Wu. Please make tell me you threw it at least. No!
You throw it, but it doesn't detonate. It does. It's just.
Ooh,
the floor. That is bad.
That is good. That is actually good. That is good.
And I drop to the floor. In the.
Yeah.
In the smoke screen. Right.
I'll fire 2 shots at each of the police officers.
There's only one police officer left standing.
Oh, in that case, he,
You kill him. He's dead.
Yeah, he's dead. He, just... Both his arms fall slack, and then he just drops down to the ground. In a pool of his own blood.
So I'll now point my pistol at the, woman and say, "Now give us all of our money back."
Make an
and
intimidate
a little
roll.
Extra.
Make an intimidate roll.
Yeah, I get my gun. I show up the guns in my backpack, and then I meet and start very quickly going through my stuff to get my backpack. No backpack. Bag. My health. My bag with medicine, and they take my wound quickly.
The Madame Patanude looks at the dead officers looks at you guys and slowly starts nodding. And she says, all of it. All of it.
And a little extra now that we've been so troubled.
No, please, just the money you stole and the money you owe. We don't well, have anymore. Not
seeing the kind of
more.
Disaster she flung us in, I think she owes us a little more than before.
Ah, god damn it, this hurts.
Just, okay. just while we're ahead.
I'm treating my wound, so can I heal a little first aid?
Yeah, make a first aid roll.
Can I help him?
Yeah, I'm fine. I stopped the bleeding, yeah.
Yeah. Madame Patinode leads you guys back down to the lobby.
How much can I heal?
You can heal. One point of damage.
Sure. Okay. When I do that, I reload. I get one of the guns, the super fun into my pistol holder, and get my bag things, and yeah. And yeah, we gonna need to leave this hotel as soon as we get the money. Get your things. We are leaving. Yeah, I'm having painful, like, this hurts. God damn it.
I'd recommend that we put on our Egyptian clothes.
Sure.
Yes.
I go to my room and dress up.
We should lock the door where the woman and the kids are. Just to be sure.
No, one of them is gonna be just guarding them. That's better. And I reload the revolver and give it to the one who is gonna help me watching over them. And, well, we're gonna change and then I'm gonna go back and be guarding them so the person that who was watching it can also dress up.
So you're going to guard them while you are in your changed uniform?
I mean, we don't have a choice too much.
I personally would say lock the door, or lock the escape routes somehow.
There's
the... And while we are outside, then we should change our clothes, or else they will give a clothing description, which would be easy for us to find.
Two of us should disguise as policemen and pretend they're arresting them, escorting the rest of us.
I'd suggest that as well, but there are just two problems. First, there are four policemen missing. Second, those police clothes have bullet holes in their clothes. So it is not an option.
Well, so. I wasn't hoping for it to work on a close inspection. But it might draw less attention to people further away watching.
No, we just dress up quickly.
You may do the best that does that out of
but no, before no, actually I have a better idea. We get the money, get lock them, make sure they can leave. Like we got them in a room that they can leave.
We're wasting time. Other policemen are already on their way. Shots have been fired. Explosions have been heard.
But no.
Igor's right. We need to make it fast now.
We need to make it very fast.
Yes.
Also, the train is driving away in a couple of minutes, I think.
Is it?
Yeah, the sun has risen already. And the train will depart at dawn,
You had that trouble with reception?
Okay, we need to hurry. Okay, I quickly go to my room, change, and yeah, I'm ready to go. I have my things with me.
Okay.
Yeah, also make sure I leave nothing left behind. Nothing that could lead to my identity. And I changed clothes.
Gonna do is pick up the bullets drop that are left.
That's a intelligent thing to do, yes.
Okay.
If you find them.
Yeah, okay, so spot hidden?
Yep, spot hidden.
I assist you in doing that.
I'm fine.
Oh, okay. I find all of it. How did I succeed?
Finally.
Yeah.
Don't worry.
Joseph, you find all the bullets.
Nice.
Okay, I found them. I think that's enough.
Okay. Now that we are done.
How many shots are fired? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
Yeah.
I count 13 bullets.
Yeah, quick. I take them from Joseph and shove it into my backpack.
Okay, run.
Yeah, we go. We just go. We don't care about the money we have enough. It's fine. We just go. And when we are outside, we actually not want to try to go faster, but not like we would cause attention. And we made sure that they are locked and barricaded them. Try to barricade them in one of their rooms.
We could always set fire to the hotel.
But they're not with locked rooms. I think a fire is already enough to destroy all the evidence.
I mean, you can do that. I'm not in pyromaniac right now, even though I should probably be. I'm gonna be rolling,
Why are there?
I'm gonna be rolling my sanity roll that later on. Definitely. Nobody knows. It doesn't matter. They are just there. Okay. So we left the hotel and go outside to start walking faster walk, let's just say. So we catch up and go get the train. We don't set the hotel on fire. And we tied female and the children and left them there.
Mm-hmm.
I'm locking them inside. And gagging them, yeah. Obviously gagging them.
Alright, you guys run from the hotel and make your way to the train station, and you're able to reach the train before it departs for Cairo.
Okay.
Okay, good.
Okay, I'm fine.
Alright, and that's where we're going to end this week's session.
Alright.
Okay.
With you boarding the final train to Cairo.
Okay, I'm just going to just fight this. Did I succeed? So I have a memory. Did I actually get this good roll? Wink.
How much money do we have anyway? I never knew.
I'll figure out the exact amount. But there's a way to do it.
Yeah, I just can't remember what it was.
I just read a note on my character sheet for something I or we as a group should do for our entire staying in Africa. We should think of false names.
Yes.
False faults.
Yeah, we should also get that.
Do we ever get to roll for increasing our skills or something like that?
Yes, after the end of certain parts of the adventure, you'll get to roll for character improvement.
During after important story arcs?
Different. Sort of. It's sort of like how in D&D they have the one of the optional ways of leveling up is by event rather than by XP. Call of Cthulhu is something very similar to that.
It works like this, yeah. So yeah, this was fun. And we are criminals.
We're criminals, all of us.
Yes, again. You guys are all criminals.
Actually, cool. They were.
You tried to throw a bomb at them.
Oh, yeah, because they were going to arrest us, and we were rotten in a Middle Eastern prison for what? For getting robbed. I mean, we were the victims here. We just defended ourselves.
What interests me now is your sleeping gas trap still active?
I never knew what happened to that.
He succeeded avoiding that, most likely.
In that case, I think it's still active, and if they try to investigate, it will be a bad awakening.
Yeah.
I assumed that I failed my intelligence roll and everything fizzled. I don't know.
Maybe it's gonna explode.
It would depend on whoever goes in the room, how good they look before they walk in.
Yeah.
All right, guys. Well, thank you so much for playing.
Thank you.
Pick up next week.
We should come up with the.